A very good afternoon, children, and welcome to our English class. Children, today we are going to start part 2 of chapter number 2 in New Voices, The New Alarm Clock. Children, you must have remembered that in part 1 we have covered first 3 paragraphs of the lesson. And in today's part 2, we are going to see the next 3 paragraphs of the lesson. I hope you all have enjoyed part 1 of the lesson and must have read the text if you have downloaded the link given in the group. So, shall I start, children? Fine. Before I start, we will just recollect what we learnt in part 1 of the lesson. I'll just ask you a few questions through which we'll come to know in that 3 paragraphs what we have covered. Children, do you remember what is the name of that girl who usually comes late to school? Yes, the name of that girl is Tina. Good, very good. Can you name her other 2 friends? She has 2 friends, no? Best friends? Yes, one is Ajay and the another girl is Deepa. Very good. What is the name of the teacher whose class was going on when Tina enters the classroom? It was English period was going on and the English teacher's name in the story is Miss Sudipta. Good, very good. So let us take a quick recap what we learnt in part 1. Tina is a small girl like you. And usually she comes late to school. Her late coming to the school, Deepa, she doesn't like it at all, being her best friend. So Ajay and Deepa, they decided to gift her a puzzle alarm clock. And what happens next? That we are going to see in today's period. Now I am going to read out the lesson paragraph wise. You two try to read with me aloud. Same time I'll explain you the lesson. An alarm clock. All I have to do is hit the snooze button. Tina laughed. This is no ordinary clock. Just set the time. Tomorrow, we will see who comes to class first, I said. I could already see Tina's mother praising us for our clever idea. A clock to challenge the queen slipper. Tina said, grinning. Now, when Ajay told Tina that we are going to give you an alarm clock as a birthday gift, so she took it very casually and she said, it will not work at all because I have an alarm clock at home. I snooze it off. After that, my parents come, my brother comes to wake me up. Still, I don't get up and I sleep again and again and again. And that's why I come to school late. And that is why she laughs when Ajay told her that we are planning to give you puzzle alarm clock. So he explains further, this is no ordinary clock, just set the time and see the fun tomorrow. At precisely 6 o'clock next morning, the clock went into action. 4 puzzle pieces scattered across the room. A red piece hit Tina and an ear-shattering ring resounded throughout the house. Tina sleepily struck the clock. no effect. She banged her fist on it. It kept ringing. Then she remembered the new alarm clock. She groggily opened her eyes. She found a puzzle piece on the bed. Now, the next day, sharp at 6 o'clock, what happens? The clock went into action and it started ringing. 4 puzzle pieces scattered across the room. The fun is here now, children. A red piece hit Tina and an ear-shattering ring resounded throughout the house. Now, sharp at 6 o'clock, the alarm was given by the clock and the 4 puzzle pieces were scattering around the room, across the room, and the red piece hit Tina. And the sound of that alarm was so loud that it was an ear-shattering ring. And it was ringing throughout the house. Tina was in deep asleep. She sleepily struck the clock as usual. She used to do the same thing daily. But no effect. So she banged her fist on it. It kept ringing. It didn't stop. And it didn't stop. That's why again she was trying to snooze it off. Then she remembered. Oh, it's not an ordinary alarm clock. That's what Ajay told me yesterday. It's the new alarm clock. She groggily opened her eyes. She found a puzzle piece on the bed. As she looked at it, she realized the wicked scheme of the clock and yelled out in despair. She dearly wanted to snuggle down, but the clock was screaming away. She jumped out of bed. 3 more pieces. Tina's brother Ashu came into her room. Can't you stop that horrible thing? Oh, I'm really trying to. Come and see if you can find 3 puzzle pieces. I have the red one, Tina cried. Now what happened? That irritating sound of the alarm clock was resounding across the house. And Tina was really getting irritated and she remembered that this is not the normal alarm clock. This is not an ordinary alarm clock. This was the hint given by my friend. So what is the special? As she looked at that puzzle piece, she then realized the wicked scheme of the clock. Then she understood, oh, this alarm is not going to get off by just pressing the button. I have to fix the 4 puzzle pieces, then only it will snooze. And she, out of anger, she yelled out in despair. She dearly wanted to snuggle down actually. She again wanted to lie down on the bed and snuggle. But the clock was screaming away. So she jumped out of bed to find the other 3 pieces of puzzle. 3 more pieces. And by that time, Tina's brother Ashu enters the room. He was also annoyed. He asked her, can't you stop that horrible thing? It is making so much noise early in the morning at 6 o'clock. Even his sleep must have got disturbed. So she replies, oh, I am really trying to. You please come and help me to find the other 3 puzzle pieces. I have the red one. Now I got 1 piece. Now you please help me to find the other 3 pieces so that we can put the alarm off. Gritting his teeth, Ashu searched the room and grabbed a blue piece near the cupboard. Tina's mother came in. Really, Tina, she started. Dad peeped in. What's going on? Soon, the entire family was searching the room. Is there no other way to turn it off? No, sniffed Tina. Smash it. No, it's a gift from my friends. Now what happened, children? Ashu, Tina's brother, also came into her room. He is also very much irritated with the noise early at the morning at 6 o'clock. There's so much loud noise around the house. And now Tina asks him also to help her to find the other three puzzle pieces. Now Ashu was very angry actually. He was literally crushing his teeth. And at the same time, he was searching the other puzzle pieces. And at once, he grabbed a blue piece near the cupboard. By that time, Tina's mother also comes in. And she starts, because it's daily seen in her room. Daily, Tina must have not got up on time, and that's why she was getting late for school. And her mother, she also comes in and she says, "Really, Tina?" And she starts. By that time, Papa also enters. Dad peeped in, what's actually going on? Why so much noise in the house early in the morning at 6 o'clock? And he also asks, what's going on? And soon, the entire family started searching the puzzle pieces. Why? Because that alarm noise was so irritating and it was so loud. And there was no other way to put it off than to fix the puzzle pieces. And for that, everyone has to find that pieces of that puzzle. So, along with Ashu and Tina, Dad and Mom also, they joins them to find the puzzle pieces in the room. By the time Ashu also asks, is there any other way? By the time we will just turn it off first and then we'll find the puzzle pieces. So Tina says, no, there is no other way to turn off the alarm clock. We have to fix the puzzle pieces, then only it will turn off. So Ashu is so much angry. He just want to smash it off. But Tina, she says, no, don't do that. It's a gift from my friends. Ashu pounced on the yellow puzzle piece under the table. I got one, Dad announced, waving a green piece as if he had won a lottery. It was a very special occasion. With trembling hands, they fit the pieces together and placed it on the clock. The family rejoiced over the silence. But only for a moment. They stared at the time, then at each other. It was 7 o'clock. Now children, what happened? Now entire family was in Tina's room. And all of them, they were searching for the puzzle pieces because the alarm voice was very irritating and it was loud enough. So they wanted to turn it off. So they joined Tina and Ashu to find the puzzle pieces so that all of them, they could fix all the pieces and the alarm should turn off. Ashu, he found one yellow puzzle piece under the table. So at once he pounced at it. He jumped at it and grabbed it like anything. By the time, even Dad also gets one puzzle piece. And he says, I got one, Dad announced, waving a green puzzle piece. And his face was so much happy that his expression were like, he had won a lottery. He was so happy. And she shouted, I got one. It was a very special occasion that they have never ever thought that at 6 o'clock, all the family members in Tina's room finding something. That is why that occasion was special. It is mentioned here. With trembling hands with waving, shivering hands. They wanted to fix it. All of them, they were very happy because now by this time they have got all the 4 puzzle pieces. So as early as possible, they wanted to fix all the pieces on the alarm clock to turn it off. they fit the pieces together and placed it on the clock, and the alarm gets turned off. The family rejoiced over the silence. They were very happy because now there was no irritating noise in the room. They were very happy, but their happiness was no, couldn't stay for a long time because they stared at the time, then it at each other, because it was 7 o'clock. I have not prepared lunch. I have not had a bath yet. My basketball practice, yeah. Back in school, we were wondering why Tina had not come early even after our brilliant efforts. Tina came later than usual. She cast really dirty look at us and I avoided looking at her. Now what happened? When Dad, Mom, Ashu, Tina, all of them, they got the puzzle pieces, they fixed it and the alarm gets silenced. And that for few seconds, there was complete silence in the room. And the family couldn't rejoice the moment. Why? Because all of them, they were very much late for all their daily activities. I have not prepared lunch, mother said, because it was almost 7 o'clock. I have not had a bath. Papa was getting late for the office and he has not yet got the bath also. And Ashu, his basketball practice, he was late for that. Now all of them, they again rushed back to their daily activities. Now back in school, we were wondering, Ajay and Deepa, now that day they were expecting Tina. At least today she will come on time because of the gift they have given. But we were wondering why Tina had not come early even after our brilliant efforts. Tina came later than usual. Means usually she was coming late to school. She came later than that time also. And she cast a really dirty look at us. She has given dirty look to her friends because whatever has happened in the morning, how much they struggled to fix the puzzle pieces and to put the alarm off. But Ajay avoided looking at her. We were having an essay test and you, Tina, can write about why came late to school today. 1,000 words. Today I will deal with you, Miss Sudipta said. Later, during recess, we heard the whole story. I got very nervous. What if Tina's mother was so angry that she never invited us to have samosas or anything? A terrible thought. When Tina entered the classroom, she was again late than usual. All the children, they were writing an essay test given by Miss Sudipta. When Tina enters the class, Miss Sudipta asks her to write an essay about 1,000 words. And what was the topic given to her? Why I came late to school today. Miss Sudipta was really too much angry with her. So she said, today I will deal with you. At least today you will tell me what is the exact reason. Why do you every time you come late to school? Then Tina must have written the essay and she has submitted. So in recess, she told her friends about what actually has happened in the morning. Later during recess, we heard the whole story. And I got very nervous. Here, I means Ajay. In entire lesson, you must have seen children. Ajay is telling this story to us. So Ajay gets nervous. So what is the reason for his nervousness? What if Tina's mother was so angry that she never invited us to have samosas or anything? He thought that Tina's mother also must have got very much angry on us, and now she will never invite us for delicious dishes prepared by her. And this thought was terrible for him. However, Miss Sudipta put things right the next day. I felt like bowing low to her. Very creative essay, I should say, Tina. Jigsaw clock. Indeed. Some imagination. An A for you. Tina smiled at us broadly. Come home today. Mom is making kheer, she whispered. And I was thrilled to hear that. Rama Ramesh. So at the end, what happens? However, Miss Sudipta put things right the next day. Ajay was thinking, now everything is out of control now. Tina is too much annoyed with us. Her family members also very much angry in the morning. So Tina's mother, she will never invite us to enjoy the delicious dishes prepared by her. But Miss Sudipta put things right the next day. How she put the things right? She likes the essay written by Tina very much. She finds it very creative, because jigsaw clock indeed is some imagination Tina has written in her essay. That's what she felt, Miss Sudipta, their English teacher. And that's why she gives A grade to her for that essay. So Tina smiled at us broadly because she was very happy. Whatever actually has happened that day, that only she wrote in her essay, and for that she got A from Miss Sudipta. So she was very happy, and so she gives a broad smile to her friends. And she whispers in very low voice, she tells her friends to come home today. Mom is making kheer. And Ajay was very much happy to hear that now again he can enjoy the delicious dishes prepared by Tina's mother. Here is the happy ending of the lesson. I enjoyed teaching this lesson very much, children. Did you enjoy this lesson? I'm sure you also. I can say this is the story must be happening in everybody's life daily, right? Come on, children. Now let us move to our next part, that is the vocabulary session. We have come across many new words, children, in these lessons. Time and again, while explaining you the lesson, I have given you the meaning of that words also. Few words we are going to see on the screen. You also try to read the word aloud and pronounce it correctly. Precisely, precisely. You can note down the words at the same time in your page or notebook, whatever you have kept with you. The first new word we have seen, precisely, precisely, precisely. The second word is resounded, resounded, resounded. Third word is groggily, groggily, groggily. And the fourth word is greeting, greeting. Precisely, resounded, groggily, and greeting. Now here I have given three words to make the sentences. The first word is whispered. 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 To speak in very low voice. Sita whispered something in Mary's ear. Sita whispered something in Mary's ear. Whispered. Sita whispered something in Mary's ear. Second word is grabbed. 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 To take hold of. Grabbed. The policeman grabbed the robber's arm. The policeman grabbed the robber's arm. Done. Third, precisely, exactly, precisely, come here precisely at 6 o'clock. Come here precisely at 6 o'clock. So we have made the sentences of whispered, grabbed, precisely. On this point, I would like to suggest to children, you just make the habit of whichever new words we learn of the lesson or the sentences we make from the given word, you just try to use that word in your own sentences and use that sentence in entire day. Try to tell it to your siblings or your parents. You can take the help of your parents also. You can tell them also to use that word to frame the sentence. And this way, your vocabulary will increase. Otherwise, what happens? We write and keep, and then again, we read it afterwards. So, try to practice that word, particular that day, entire day, so that it gets fixed in your mind. Next, let us see the synonyms. The first word, rejoiced. 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 Rejoiced, delighted. Rejoiced, delighted. Second word is brilliant. BRILLINT. Brilliant means bright. It's brilliant idea, bright idea. BRILLINT. Brilliant, bright. Third word is horrible. 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 Horrible, awful. AWFUL, awful. Fourth word is greeting. GRITING. Greeting. Meaning, pressing the top and bottom teeth together, often in anger. Pressing the top and bottom teeth together, often in anger. So, we have seen the meanings of rejoiced, brilliant, horrible, and greeting. Let us move to our next slide and see the Antonyms. The first word, arrive. Antonym of arrive is depart. Arrive, depart. Second word, huge. Huge, small. Huge, small. Third word, thoughtful. Thoughtless. Thoughtful, thoughtless. Fourth one, ordinary, special. Ordinary, special. Now let us move to our next and the last part of the lesson, children. I'll ask you a few questions. You have to try to answer the question by recollecting the story. Ready? The first question. What excuse did Tina give her teacher for coming late? You remember when Tina came late in the first paragraph we have seen? She came late, so Miss Sudipta asked her, why are you late to the school? So what excuse did Tina give the teacher for coming late? Yes. Very good. Tina told her teacher that she had missed the school bus. Tina told her teacher that she had missed the school bus. Very good. Let us move to our next question. Why was Tina's friend Deepa annoyed with her? Why was Tina's friend Deepa annoyed with her? You remember when Ajay gives her Sudoku puzzle to solve, Deepa doesn't like it. Why was she annoyed with her? Yes. Just check whether your answer is correct here. Deepa was annoyed with Tina for coming late again. Deepa was annoyed with Tina for coming late again. Next question. What was Tina doing instead of her grammar work? What was Tina doing instead of her grammar work? Yes, correct. Tina was solving a Sudoku puzzle instead of her grammar work. Tina was solving a Sudoku puzzle instead of her grammar work. Next question, children. Why couldn't the alarm clock be shut off? Today I explained you why it couldn't get, why couldn't the alarm clock be shut off? Was it the ordinary alarm clock? No, then yes, the alarm clock couldn't be shut off as all the pieces of jigsaw had to be placed on the clock to turn it off. The alarm clock couldn't be shut off as all the pieces of jigsaw had to be placed on the clock to turn it off. And the last question, children. Did the new alarm clock succeed in its purpose of making Tina reach school in time? What do you think? Did the new alarm clock succeed in its purpose of making Tina reach school in time? Correct. No, The new alarm clock did not succeed in its purpose of making Tina reach school in time, as she and her family spent a lot of time trying to find the pieces of the clock. So that day also, the new alarm clock did not succeed in its purpose. Here we have come to an end of this part 2 of chapter number 2, The New Alarm Clock by Rama Ramesh. I hope, children, you have enjoyed both the parts and the story as well. With this part also, I have given you some activity in the worksheet. Solve it and submit it on time. Thank you very much. Sai Ram.